How can I pursue the truth when they can block each step I take?
Henry, you have come too far. Remember what you have at stake.
John, I know I'm right. I must let my vision guide me. I'm so weary of the fight. There's so little left inside me.
If you know that you are right, then you've got to see it through. You've got to see it through.
7 years ago, I started out on this alone. Now it's alone, I'll see it through to its conclusion. Who are they to judge what I am doing? They know nothing of the endless possibilities I see. It's ludicrous, I'm bound by their decision.
Seems vision is a word they've never heard.
If it mattered less, I'd treat them with derision. It's absurd.
And yet, the fact remains. Those bastards hold the reins.
If you live around here, you need cash in the bank. Cause the houses round here are all flashy and swag. And the front bit is what's called a facade.
If you live around here, you need lots of panache. If you live in town, dear, then you must cut a dash. It isn't my idea to create a facade.
Here tonight it's festive, but the guests are getting restive, cause the guests of honor's causing a dilemma.
Dr. Jekyll is tardy for his own engagement party, his betrothal to Sir Danvers' daughter.
The best, I must say.
Sir Danvers, you've done it again.
The food is delicious.
So are the men.
Your Highness, dear ladies, the pleasure is mine. A party announcing a marriage must shine. The good Dr. Jekyll's an admirable choice. Occasions like this give us cause to rejoice. It's not every day that one's daughter's engaged.
She seems to have left several suitors enraged.
Well, one chap for sure over there, Simon Stride, was confident he would make Lisa his bride. Which just goes to show that however well matched, one shouldn't count chickens or brides till they're hatched.
Sir Danvers, we all drink and toast.